Welcome. We are so glad that you joined us today. We're going to talk about some tough issues.
Yeah.
My guest is Kimberly Smith Hyland. She's a missionary to South Sudan. She has suffered through some horrific circumstances. We're going to talk about why she stays in South Sudan, tries to help, even after all the tragedy and heartbreak. Amazing.
Can't wait for that. But closer to home, there are currently, get this, over 60 million people in the world looking for a home amid the refugee crisis in our globe. It affects all of us, Cheryl.
Yeah, and it affects this country. This week, the first of our Canadian troops are going to arrive in Mali to support the United Nations peacekeeping mission in that country. It is so dangerous.
Absolutely. An armed rebellion in 2012 left over 250,000 people on the run. And just this past week, 36 civilians were killed in a militia attack.
You know, you think of the parents right now whose kids are over there, the spouses. So many people are concerned about this. And it's a snapshot of the need for safety in this world. You know, people are coming here to Canada hoping for a peaceful future, especially for their families and their kids.
Absolutely. But unfortunately, this week, the mayor of the country's largest city, Toronto, had to declare refugee shelters full. That means, as you were just sharing with me, that means a lot of dorms, of schools where refugees are being kept right now. What happens come September when students are back in their dorms? What happens to these refugees?
Yeah, they're asking the provincial government, the federal government. They're saying they need help. They're not getting it yet. And of course, it's always people, like not just numbers, not just faces, but actual people with kids, you know, who are in the middle of this. Where are they going to go? It's such a challenging circumstance. And Maggie, I was thinking today that a lot of people say, like, I don't know what my purpose is in the world. And I think something you can do, even if you're super busy, if you're a stay-at-home mom, if you're a shut-in, wherever your situation, like, we can pray the news.
Yeah, I love that. I love that term, pray the news.
Yeah, see what's on the headline, ask God to intervene. We're going to do that right now.
Absolutely. 30 seconds, let's go.
Okay. Am I doing it?
Yeah. Go ahead.
God, we just ask you right now to intervene in this situation, Lord. We pray for those refugees here in Canada who have no place to go, that you would open up doors. God, we pray for peacekeepers that are going to Mali right now and around the world, that they would be protected and that they would be safe. And I thank you that you see them, Father. So protect them and comfort the hearts of the family that is left here.
Amen. There's more to come. 100 Huntley Street. Stay with us.